you. Hold the applause. No, keep going. Yes, second time up here. Thank you for having me back. I just want to give a shout out to everybody who's sharing their personal demons with us tonight. I'm going to change things up and try to add a little lightness to the evening by sharing you a very true story that still involves very real monsters, very real gods, or at least the evocation and drinking thereof. The story takes place in the oh-so-hedonistic and godless land of Texas. Never go there. Please, save yourselves. I made that mistake once. But I was there of my own accord, as you do. And I was invited to an event called Ant Guard, which, if you don't know what it is, it's a lot like Dagger Hair. If you don't know what that is, it's a lot like SCA, but with foam weaponry. And probably more drinking. So our story starts on a lovely, fascinating evening. There's underage drinking, but this was 13 years ago, so I don't think it matters anymore. I was 20 years old. We were having a send-off to a previous participant who had unfortunately passed away. Everybody was invited to take a shot of Captain Morgan's spiced rum. You know this is going to be a great story when it starts with Captain. I had never been much of a drinker. I still am not, for very good reasons, due to monsters that run in my family. But I thought, one shot's not going to hurt. I'm a big, beefy person. So I have a shot. Okay, great. Walk over here. Hey, people are having a drink. I wonder what they're drinking. This is pixie juice. If you do not know what that is, I do not blame you. You take a red Solo cup. You fill it halfway with vodka, the other half with Mountain Dew, and you pour in a pixie stick. And I thought, this sounds delicious. Can I try a sip? They said, sure. We'll just make you your own cup, and if you don't like it, we'll finish it off. I had three of them. Over the course of 15 minutes. I'm feeling pretty good. This is a pretty big campground. It's dark in Texas, as it is, for more than one way. I'm wandering around. Now, this is in Ant Guard. It's medieval reenactment, but it's fantasy reenactment. So we have characters of all kinds, and among them prevalently are trolls. One of the rules of being a troll is that you have to be drunk all the time. They took it literally. So I encountered a group of trolls, and they were drinking and making merry out of a 2-gallon jug of high C, not so pure juice. I asked them what it was. I'm feeling pretty good. They said, this is berry grog. They did not explain what was in it. I did not ask. I had about a red Solo cup's worth. Just so that you are aware, about an hour's time has passed since that shot of Captain Morgan's. I'm feeling really good. I need a little bit of help getting around now, and for some reason, I'm constantly asking people if I'm drunk. Because I didn't feel drunk, but I was compelled to ask. That should have been a good indication, but it wasn't. So then I'm wandering around, I get to a pavilion with a bunch of other people. I don't know anybody here, but they invite me to come and have a drink with them. Okay! They hand me a 16-ounce Coors Light. That's pretty much soda by this point. I down it. About 2 hours have passed at this point. I've had no other beverages, no food. I literally am going to my tent at a 45-degree angle. I get to my tent. I think I tumble rolled in. I'm not quite sure. There are blank spots in my memory. I'm not sure why. But I'm there with my friend who had brought me here, and for some reason, now just as a bit of backstory, I had graduated from massage therapy school a couple of months prior to this. So drunkenly, I start giving her a neck and back massage, which she said was the best she'd ever had. Now, I've talked about a lot of monsters here, but you're probably wondering, where do the gods come into this? You're about to find out. Because I looked at my friend. I don't know what compelled me to do it. But I said, what would happen if I screamed, blood for Odin, at the top of my lungs at this very moment? This was her response. Now, just to paint the landscape for you, imagine a loose leaf sheaf of paper, landscape, so it's on its long way side. That's about the general shape and size of this campground. We're in the bottom furthest corner. Literally, if we were 2 feet further out, we would no longer be on the campground. We'd be down in the creek, about 2 feet away from the mooing cows. There are bugs and birds and cows in the background. There are people making merry all across the campground, fires crackling, people laughing, probably doing unmentionable things that I'm glad I don't know about. And so, I did it. Blood for Odin! For a solid 30 seconds, not a single sound could be heard but the crackling of campfires. The cows stopped mooing. The bugs stopped chirping. The birds either took off or shut up, I'm not sure which. And everybody within the general hearing range, which probably wasn't very good considering how much alcohol I consumed, but that's not the point. No noise, but fire for 30 seconds, and then slowly noise starts trickling back in. It's around that point I think I passed out, because next thing I know, it's morning. I wake up. I don't have a hangover, but I'm just kind of groggy. So I stumble around, my friend makes sure I get some lemonade and water in me so that I don't wish for death or that my head would burst like a ripened goose egg. And then eventually we take off, but that's just my personal encounter with gods and monsters therein and thereof. Thank you.